Welcome back, guys. It's time to continue on. I did manage to go down there and take care of that undead dragon, pick up that shield, and there was a soul down there as well, and we got our souls. So now it's time to take on Sens Fortress. This place is loaded down with traps. The first one is just right inside the door here. But the really neat thing is, most of these traps can be used against the enemies as well. Unless they're smart and walk to the side like that. Now you deal with both these guys at once. How do they like soul arrows? Well, if they got their shield up, it doesn't bother them much. Aw, come on. Put your shield down. Gotcha. Now, can I parry these guys? I can. Okay, this area just got a lot easier. I've never parried these guys before. Okay, with the delays. Okay, yeah, so this area just got a lot easier. I might even switch. It's this target shield. Because their parry window's kind of in a weird place. He likes to use delayed attacks as well. And what was that? Something just fell. That was the guy on the bridge here. I wonder what he was doing. Oh no! That was close. There's a lot of these swinging axes in this area. Okay, here's probably where I need my grass crest shield out again. You can push up against these blades, just don't be in front of them when they come back. Let me parry these guys. I'll set that off. Did he set it off? I don't know where the pressure plate was. Two large titanite. Oh man, I almost want to go back and upgrade this. Yeah, we'll be alright. That guy down there is passive unless you attack him. There's a guy out here that you can just stand right here and keep him out there. And this boulder trap will come by and knock him down. Doesn't seem like it's doing much damage, though. Okay. Boulder screwed up my parry. Okay, enough. You're gonna kill me. Okay, we'll wait for the next one. Go, 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 go. Hide right here for a little bit. And you're not gonna get out of the way. How do you like boulders? Okay, now. Ring a of steel protection. I believe that just boosts up your physical defense. Yes. Okay. There's some stuff down there. Where's it safe to drop down at? Ah, I missed it. Here's onion, bro.
Oh ho! Ah, where did you come from? Splendid view, as I tell you.
You guys are always so happy.
Ah, can you see my fight? Yes, indeed. I've run up against a wall, or a ball, to be precise. I'm afraid I'm a bit too tough. Running those things. So here I sit in quite a pickle, but who knows? Perhaps we'll have another development.
So optimistic.
Perhaps I could try some rolling. Bah, no job. My head is big.
Whoever wrote the script for him, absolute genius. Okay. Where do I drop down then? Right here? Okay. Chateau. Can I use it? Dexterity. I don't think I'm gonna increase my strength or dexterity anymore. Well, no, I need to. Later on for the Moonlight Greatsword. That's gonna be my endgame weapon. I think I said I needed 16 strength. I think my dexterity was fine. I'll have to look that up again. Okay, I don't think I'm making it to the second one. Okay, now. Another trap. Where does it come from? So let's try this. Hit him once. There's four different paths that this boulder can come rolling down. I have no clue how that hit me. There's four different paths that that boulder can come rolling down. For some reason, it tracks you. Whichever path you're down, it will adjust to where you're at. Which is irritating. And there's no real easy way to shut it off, either. And here we have our first mimic. I remember this. Of course, it's too low to hit. We better buff our weapon curves. They do have insta-kill attacks. Okay, this is kind of a tight room to be fighting him in. There's the insta-kill attack. Well, that wasn't so bad. Lightning spear. What's the damage like on end? 144, 140 foot, 288. I can't can use it. 288 compared to 138. You know what? We're using this for a while. Okay, here's another trap. The blood kind of gives it away. You have to step off this lift before you reach the ceiling, or else it'll kill you. This area was one of the hardest for me in my first playthrough. But once you learn where all the traps are, it's not so bad at all. There's a lot of really cheap kills. Really cheap deaths. Okay, which way is this going? That way. So we can explore everything down here. Where does that go? Oh, okay. You have to rotate that to make the ball come rolling down there, and it will break through that wall. And there's some hidden things back there. I think there's an NPC and some loot. Okay, we had to go this way. Hopefully that didn't reset. That looks like we're good. What the hell is this? What happened there? You can swing him! That is one of the coolest things I've ever seen. How did that happen? It wasn't like that when I killed him. Did I knock him out? Yes, I can. I've never seen anything like that before. He's like stuck there like a swing. Okay, I heard it resetting. Yeah, it's coming down here again. Okay, there's some loot back there. Check that out real quick. Oh, the covetous gold serpent ring. That increases item discovery, which will help farming humanity from those rats. As far as I know, there's nothing down here. I went down there multiple times, and I never found anything. Now we gotta deal with this elevator again. Step on, turn around, and walk back towards where you walked on. And we'll step off. Okay, this was the locked door. And I guess it doesn't open from that side. So I need to rotate this. And that will send the boulders down that way. That block that knocked through the wall. Should be able to take out that guy that was standing on there as well. It's off this way. Can't go that way. Where are you going? And this is the way we need to go. Through this hallway. Check what's down here real quick. Okay. Drop down on this guy. I'm More souls. If I remember right, there is a false wall somewhere up here. I could be mistaken. And there's a way to get down there too. There's like four Titanite demons down there. Slumbering Dragon Crest. I think that makes your footsteps silent. I can't remember how you get down there. I know you don't just don't drop down there. I guess this is the way we need to go to get back up. Okay, it was there. How do you get down there? False wall here? Huh. I've almost always just skipped over that area down there because I'm always way too underleveled to be taking on those guys. No clue how you get down there. And where did those guys come from? That's where I came into Sens Fortress. That's the entrance. Whatever. Not gonna worry about it. Looks like the trap's reset. And then this wall should be knocked through. It is. Still coming this way. No. I'll have to switch that before we go down there. I think I need a key to open those cages anyway. Oops, went too far. We'll worry about finding the bonfire first before we missed it. Always do too much exploring. And that's resetting, I can hear it. I probably could have made that run up there. Okay, so how do you get... There's a door that didn't open from the side I was trying to go through it. I don't know how to get to the other side. If I could turn that annoying ass boulder off, that would make things easier. Yeah, okay. There it is. Looks like there's a path going down right there. Maybe it's up further ahead. Okay, so now we gotta find that doorway. There's a trap right there. Here's where these blades start getting really annoying. I think you gotta run through all five of them right here. Is it five or four? I can't tell. Okay, here we go. way too early. Okay, don't kill me here. I said, don't kill me here. There's one up these stairs. Okay. What was he hiding? That just looks like it's gonna kill me. Parrying is faster, but it's riskier. More large titanite. We're getting really close to the bonfire. I think all I have left is just one more of these blade traps, and we've got it. But this is the hardest blade trap, because you got this dickhead constantly shooting lightning at you. Oh shoot, he's got just a sliver of health left. Okay, that makes things much easier. Now you can just take my time. Normally you just gotta make this in one straight run. You can't stop. You gotta go right through here, stop very briefly right here, and then continue on. No! That was pretty close. Both the arrows and that hole. Yeah, normally I don't have a really useful ranged weapon to take out that guy, so I have to do the hard run. This with all these pitfalls. And pressure plate right there. Okay, the bonfire is right up here, but let's go down here first. Shield? I don't think I've ever seen these guys do a shield bash before. Titanite shard. I was hoping it was a sword. Flamestone Paintling. That'll be useful later on. Okay. Right here, we have a giant up at the top of that tower right there, throwing massive fire bombs down at us. As long as you stay on the stairs. Oh, no, I lied. Never mind. As long as you stay at the bottom of the stairs, he can't hurt you. All we're gonna do is run up here. The easiest way to handle this area is just to keep moving, don't stop. We go off the side here, and here's our bonfire. see, what, 25 minutes, so we better call the episode here. Next video, we'll finish up at this area. See you then.